As humanity moves progressively closer to a completely carbon-neutral future, ideas considering mass-scale green energy production seem more and more appealing. A common idea is to cover deserts such as the Sahara in solar panels. It would take a fairly unproductive area on Earth and turn it into an energy farm that could potentially power the world. However, there is some well-deserved skepticism about a project of this magnitude. After all, the Sahara is 9.2 million kilometers squared. Perhaps the most prominent issue is the change in albedo that placing solar panels on such a large area would have. Side note, albedo is the measure of reflectivity of the sun's rays. For example, snow has a fairly high albedo because it reflects lots of light that hits it, whereas asphalt has a low albedo because it absorbs much of the sun's energy. On a small scale, such as a road, this does not dramatically alter the climate. However, in such a massive scale, there would certainly be repercussions. A study conducted showed that just 20% of the Sahara covered in solar panels creates temperature differences between the ocean and land, causing more water to evaporate. This creates monsoon-like rain in the Sahara, which gives rise to vegetation. Abundant vegetation gives rise to even more evaporation through transpiration. This seems perfect, as we could both generate energy and create a thriving rainforest, but that is not the case, as vegetation also has a relatively low albedo, absorbing plenty of light. This subsequently means that covering 20% of the Sahara leads to a 1.5 degrees Celsius rise in local desert temperatures and a global 0.16 degrees Celsius rise, whereas covering 50% of the desert leads to a local 2.5 degrees Celsius rise and a global 0.93 degrees Celsius rise. Though that temperature rise is not uniform, and the most affected will be the poles, which subsequently will lead to the polar ice caps melting, lowering the albedo of Earth, further compounding the effect of global warming. However, if we do the math, we see that we won't need to cover anywhere near 20% of the Sahara Desert to produce energy for the entire world. The Sahara receives about 2,000 kilowatt hours of solar radiation per meter squared per year. And with the typical 20% efficiency of solar panels, they can produce 400 kilowatt hours of electricity per meter squared per year. The total global consumption of electricity in 2019 was 23,400 terawatt hours. This means that about 58,500 kilometers squared of land will need to be converted into solar panels to generate the world's electricity. As such, only 0.6% of the Sahara will need to be covered in solar panels to power the entire world. Therefore, the issues of melting the ice caps and turning the Sahara into a rainforest are basically non-existent. Though, it does prompt the question, how many solar panels will be needed? The average solar panel is 1 meter by 1.6 meters. A square with an area of 58,500 kilometers squared has sides of about 241 kilometers. That means that there would be 151,000 solar panels on one side and 241,000 on the other side. This results in a massive 36 billion solar panels being required. Of course, this would certainly be no small feat for mankind. Each solar panel, along with the mounting, uses about 10 kilograms of aluminum or aluminum alloys, meaning that 360 billion kilograms of aluminum would be required. Last year, about 64 billion kilograms of aluminum was extracted and refined, meaning the project would require about 6 years' worth of stockpiled aluminum. To put that into perspective, 360 kilograms of aluminum could form a solid cube more than half a kilometer in side length. It would stand taller than the Empire State Building. In addition, each solar panel has about 4.6 grams of silver wiring in it. This means a total of 171 million kilograms of silver would be required, which equates to a 7-year stockpile. That could form a solid 25-meter-tall cube. The sheer volume of the resources is massive, bordering on impossible. The carbon output of creating 36 billion solar panels is also another consideration. the manufacturing of a solar panel produces about 50 grams of CO2 per kilowatt hour. This means producing about 1.1 trillion kilograms of CO2. Compared to the 36 trillion kilograms released last year, it would only account for about 3% of carbon emissions. Furthermore, it would make up for this by replacing all of the coal power plants, which produce about 975 grams of CO2 per kilowatt hour, a 20 times difference. Clearly, there are issues of transporting the energy, limiting such a project, not to mention the political side, as the Sahara spans several countries. Furthermore, when we do finally convert to completely green energy, it won't come from a single source, but many, like wind, hydro, and solar. Nonetheless, large-scale solar farms are already beginning to grow in popularity and will be seen more and more in the coming decades. Anyway, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you all soon with a brand new video.